Now, next we will see that there are many physical quantities, but majority of them are related to each other. For example, the quantity speed. Speed is given by the formula distance upon time. Naturally, the unit of speed will be given by unit of distance upon unit of time. So in MK system, the unit of speed will be meter per second, and in CGS system, it will be centimeter per second. Now work out the area of your classroom. We must find out the length and the breadth of the classroom as they are in the form of that the classrooms are in the form of a rectangle. Now the product of the length and the breadth, it gives you the area of the classroom. Now standards of the fundamental quantities. As the standard of mass, a solid cylinder made of platinum iridium alloy is kept in the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Paris. As per the international agreement, this mass is called 1 kilogram. Now, official accurate copies of this prototype are kept in the standardizing laboratories or the institutes all over the world. So, all of you are understanding it, that the cylinder which is made up of platinum iridium alloy, it is taken as 1 kg and all other masses, they are compared with it and that is taken as 1 kilogram. Two fine lines are engraved on a platinum iridium bar kept in the International Bureau of the Weights and the Measures at Paris. The distance between two lines is accepted as 1 meter. Now, accurate copies of this prototype are also made and distributed to the standardizing laboratories or the institutes all over the world. Now, the time required here. So, this is how the meter, this fixed distance 1 meter, it will remain same all over the world. Now the time required for one revolution of the earth is measured by means of an accurate device. This time is taken as 24 hours. Now to standardize 1 second, 1 hour is considered to have 60 minutes and 1 minute the 60 seconds. And this is how 1 second is being calculated. Now let us next see this one, the fundamental quantities. Now it is enough to select a few out of the many quantities and standardize their units. You can see from the above examples that units of the quantities length and time need to be standardized. Such quantities are called fundamental quantities and their units are called standard units. Of course, standard fundamental unit must be available to all and it must not be variable. Now the international system of units. An international system of units based on 7 fundamental units called System International is currently used all over the world. It is called as the metric system. Now the names and the symbols of the units of the fundamental quantities, length, time and mass in this system are given in the following table. Like the length, name of the unit is meter and symbol of the unit is small m. Mass is measured in kilogram, its symbol is kg. Time in second and symbol is s. Total 7 fundamental quantities are there, but at this stage in 7th standard we have to learn about the 3 fundamental quantities: length, mass and time. Now these 2 questions are there. What is the atomic clock and where it is kept? Now atomic clock, it is constructed by using this one, atoms of the particle for the calibration, and it is kept in a satellite and all to find out the accurate measurement of the time, because for launching the satellites even a fraction of the second makes a difference, and in that case the clock should be very accurate. So in satellites here, these atomic clocks are being used. Now how is the velocity of the light used for determining the standard meter? Now the velocity of the light is taken as 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. So the distance traveled by the or in 1 second, the distance traveled by the light, it is considered as the 1 meter. So this is how the velocity of the light is used to find accurately the distance of 1 meter. Now when man felt the need to measure things, he started by using the parts of his own body for the purpose. In Egypt in ancient times, the distance from the man's elbow to the tip of the middle finger, it was called as cubit. Now this measure would differ from person to person like a handspan. Therefore, the cubit of the king was considered as the standard. So in olden times, we weighed gold as in a unit called gunj. An hourglass was used for measuring time. So have you seen this one hourglass for measuring time? The sand is filled in that hourglass. And then that, now also in some of the games and all that hourglass is used, so that the time taken, now that the hourglass, it consists of two parts. One is of here, so the sand is filled in the part, and then the time taken by the sand to come to the other part of the glass, that is taken as 1 hour. Now identify the wrong methods of measurement shown in the picture and explain why they are wrong. Now here see, in the first picture, the handspan is used for measuring the length of the string. It is wrong because the length of the handspan will be different for different people. Naturally, this length of the string will be different for different people. Then scale is used for measuring the length of the string. This is the right method. Then the glass is used for measuring the volume of the milk. Now this here, measuring cylinder should be used for measuring the volume of the milk or any liquid. Then this method here, last one, this is the right method. Then length of the string is used for measuring, scale is used for measuring the length of the string. This also is the right method. Then importance of the accurate measurement. Now how accurate the measurement must be done depends on the purpose. Accordingly, an appropriate device has to be used for the measurement. A measurement of the substances that are precious, of great importance and used in very small quantities is done meticulously and accurately. Now due to the advancement in technology, devices that measure very small magnitudes of quantities like distance, mass, time and temperature are now available. For example, distance and time in connection with important sports competition. Then mass of the gold. Gold is also very costly. 10 grams of gold cost 50,000 rupees. So 1 gram is equal to, will cost around 5,000 rupees. So a minute change in the measurement of the gold will be there. Then there is a big difference in the money. So that's why all these things, mass of the gold should be measured very accurately. Then same way, body temperature. A slight degree in the change in temperature will have a big effect on the health of the person's body. So the body temperature should also be measured accurately. Then measure major causes of the errors in measurement. First one is not using the appropriate device. And second one, not using the device properly. Now, do you really get as many liters of petrol as the petrol pump indicates? To ensure this, it is necessary to check it against the standard measure from time to time. So this is called as the standardization. Similarly, it is necessary to standardize the weights and the measures used in the market. Now, while buying things at grocery shop, the vegetable market, remember to look out for the following and tell your guardians also to do so. First one, Does the balance carry the stamp of standardization by the Department of Weights and Measures? Is the balance stable? Is the pointer of the balance upright? This we should find out when you go to the shop. Is the weight made of the metal? Now, most of the time they use the stones or other things as the weight. How is the balance held? Here they don't hold the balance properly and just only the pointer is held vertical. Has the underside of the pan of the balance been tampered with? Sometimes at the bottom the magnet is attached to the pan, which is made up of iron. So that also, so there will be a variation in the weight of the objects which you are measuring. So thus we see that here. Now, so to prevent the consumers from being cheated, the weight and the measure subdivision function as the part of the Food, Urban Supply and Consumer Protection Division of the government. Officers of this subdivision visit different places from time to time and ascertain whether the weights and the balances used being used are proper or not. It is binding by the law to use standard weights and measures. It is also the function of the weight and the measure subdivision to grant licenses for the production, sales and repairs of the weights and measures.